Sometimes you might be deep into a Raycast command, like creating a snippet, but you might need to reference something in some other app. So you close Raycast, do what you gotta do, and when you come back to it, it's exactly how you left off. This is cool, but some people might not like that pressing the Raycast hotkey shows something other than the root search. That's where the pop to root search setting comes into play. You have several delay options, and you can even choose it to immediately pop back to root after closing Raycast. One of the greatest things about Raycast is how customizable it is. For us, it's crucial that you can make it work for you. That's why we have the What's in My Raycast series, where guests come on the show and they share the setup and we can learn from them. Now, obviously, we ship the product, so we believe that the default settings work best for most people, but we love being able to tweak some of these things and make sure that your setup works exactly as you need. So let's go over some Raycast settings that you absolutely must know about and that you can change at any time if you want. Oh, and to access them, you can always open up Raycast and press Command Comma. If you're a pro subscriber, one setting you must absolutely know about is Cloud Sync. All you have to do is turn it on to guarantee that all of the settings that you change in Raycast are kept the same across all your computers. Now, if you're not a pro subscriber, that's fine. You can manually export and import your settings at any time. You can even configure an export schedule to have this happen automatically. In fact, this is pretty useful for pro subscribers as well, in case you change things often and you might want to revert to a previous setting. This is a very controversial one. A lot of people get behind compact mode, but I personally like to leave it off. If you like a cleaner look that takes less screen real estate, you can always turn it on here. If you use the HyperKey, which is basically assigning all four modifiers at the same time, you'll be happy to check this little box under the Advanced tab in Raycast Settings. It replaces all of the HyperKey occurrences with this star symbol, leaving the root search with a much cleaner look. I'm not personally a HyperKey user just yet. However, I'm running out of hotkeys recently, so I might have to join the club real soon, especially because... Actually, don't worry about it. In Raycast commands that deal with text, like snippets, clipboard history, AI commands, and the emoji picker, you have two options for what the primary action is. That is, if you want the action to paste to the active app when you press enter, or if you want to copy the result to the clipboard. You can find this setting by searching for the command and pressing Shift Command Comma, or going to the AI Settings tab if you want to change the behavior for AI commands. Now, whichever action you pick for the primary one, remember that the other option is always available as a secondary action by pressing Command Enter instead. Specifically in Clipboard History, there is this interesting setting that allows you to decide whether an item should move to the top of the list after an action. If you're pasting a lot of things in sequence, you might want to leave that off. Raycast has a built-in way to capture a screenshot of the UI so you can report bugs, share cool stuff, or showcase extensions you're building. To use it, all you have to do is set a hotkey here under Advanced Settings. I love having hotkeys for some of my apps, like Option C for Calendar, Option B for Browser, Option S for Slack, etc. The way that these hotkeys work is that when you press them, it will bring that app into focus. And if you press it again, it will hide it. So you can toggle the app very quickly without even lifting your hands off of the keyboard. But if you prefer it so the hotkey only focuses the app but doesn't hide it, then you can also do that by disabling this checkbox under the Applications folder settings in the Extensions tab. In the My Schedule settings, there's an option to show the Open Camera command before joining a meeting. That allows you to quickly preview yourself before jumping on that call. Our team meeting happens at 6 a.m. in Bruno's time zone, so you can be absolutely sure that he relies on that setting. Talking about the Open Camera command, when we first released it, the Take Photo action would include the Raycast UI and a bit of the background with the photo. Needless to say, not everybody liked this.
I don't think it sells the brand as much as you think it does.
So we turned that off by default. However, you can reactivate this behavior in the open camera settings. A lot of people requested that we change the AI chat submit button to command enter instead of just enter. So we gave you the option. This is available under the AI chat settings in the extensions tab. I prefer to leave mine as the default though. Last but not least, a super useful one we actually mentioned in the previous video that we released last week. By leaving this on, you can make it so that the left half and right half window management command cycle through a few other options when you press them repeatedly. This means you get a lot more window management commands without having to remember new hotkeys. Check out this video for a full tutorial on window management. These are just some of the Raycast settings you can tweak to customize your experience. Did I forget some? Probably. You know the drill. Drop them down below. Subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.